Back again, I should start by apologizing. We cut, the battery went off. I'm still joined by Mr. Tsvangirai, Collins Tsvangirai. Once again, welcome back to the show.
Thank you very much. Welcome.
Okay. We have this troubling question. Luke, Chamisa, Elizabeth, Collins, Edwin, Mutsuri. All these people, where is the address of the truth? Your brother is in hospital where we are.
The problem that I can see now,
yeah,
is Luke Tamborinyoka,
yeah,
is the spokesman of the of Morgan Tsvangirai, but the problem now we are facing is he is telling the world that he communicated with Morgan Tsvangirai, of which we are here. We never saw Luke Tamborinyoka, we never saw him. Nelson Chamisa, we never saw him. But to Nelson Chamisa, I talked to him that he was not able to see Morgan. Furthermore, we have a problem now that on the 7th,
yeah,
they communicated, they are saying they communicated with Morgan, yet he never came up to, he never came to South Africa. We never saw him in South Africa.
On the contrary, the fact is that Morgan was looking for Luke.
Morgan was looking for Luke so that he can communicate what he wanted to be done in Zimbabwe.
Did Morgan get hold of Luke?
No.
Are you sure?
Because he even went to say to his PA, Anna Mzidziwa, to call Luke so that he can call Morgan. But this did not happen.
So are you confidently saying Luke was creating facts that didn't exist?
That one, I think, it's not true. It's not true.
So first, the letter, you are confidently saying you are not aware, you have no personal knowledge.
I have no personal knowledge about that.
And you are also saying that even if the letter to appoint Chamisa was signed by your brother, it would be very strange for him to then see Mutsuri on the 8th.
On the 8th. It would be strange because if he had not given the authority to Elias Mutsuri, it would have been difficult for us to understand why he could see Mutsuri on the 8th when he had already appointed Chamisa.
Okay. Then he saw him on the 9th again.
In the morning before he went for X-ray.
And there was no problem.
There was no problem.
Between the two of them.
They told each other, bye, but go and unite people so that they can register.
Okay. There are people who would accuse you of meddling in politics of MDCT, that you are not a public office bearer and you are not a spokesman, because you are saying that the spokesman is not speaking to the principal. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. I cannot speak for the party.
Yeah.
But for our family, I can speak because I am on the ground, I am where Morgan is, and I have no problem in saying that these people never saw Morgan.
So you have no personal knowledge?
I have no personal knowledge, and I don't even want to meddle in the politics because that gives me nothing in the end.
Okay, so at the end of the day, as we speak today, what do you think could have informed Luke to say, I've spoken to Morgan, when in truth and fact, that never took place?
Because Nelson was here on the 7th.
On the first,
yes, but did not see Morgan. I think, I don't know the arrangement that were there between Luke and
Because there is an issue which remains unresolved. The trip to Cape Town by Mutsuri and other office bearers, did your brother know about it, or it was a surprise?
No, that one is with the politicians. I am not a politician. I don't have the schedule of what they are doing within the party.
Okay. Because there is an allegation that your brother was not happy that the meeting took place. And you may not comment on things. Feel free to say this falls outside mine.
Yeah, because myself, I'm being not a politician and not interested in politics. I have no idea of their schedule of how they travel.
But you never heard the whispers from your brother complaining about a meeting taking place and people seemingly wanting to dethrone your brother by going to talk about a coalition with the likes of Jonathan Moyo.
You have no idea.
Okay. So we now know from your side, you never saw any anger, anything being expressed in relation to Mutsuri, any strong words, anything.
Because he was even encouraging with Mutsuri in his whilst Morgan was sitting on his bed. He even emphasized that people should go and register and unite people so that you can go and vote.
I understand there are pictures.
Yes, that you can prove.
That can prove your vision.
Yeah, the pictures
that
are...
That actually, there are people who are doubting that Mutsuri is telling the truth, that he actually met your brother. You are saying that there are pictures that confirm.
There are.
Proof of life.
Proof of life.
Okay.
Yeah.
So your brother is not in a coma.
He's not in a coma. He's not on the life support. He's responding to medication. So that's what we are wishing, that he gets out of the hospital.
Okay.
And gets home.
So with this spokesperson, after the 9th, have you been able to speak to Luke, or are you aware of any communication?
I've never communicated with Luke.
But there are text messages that are showing that Morgan is communicating on Twitter, and I know previously, I'm just repeating it so that the public out there can know that actually Morgan is not tweeting.
The problem I think is there is that Luke, being Morgan's spokesman, he has got the tweet account, and he is tweeting to say Morgan is the one who is writing. Oh. And this surprises me, to say when they are saying Morgan is incapacitated, how can he tweet when
so there is a contradiction.
There is a contradiction of what
but
they are
saying.
But
nobody is caring to resolve it.
No.
So here we are. That's the Zimbabwe of 2018.
Luke should prove to the MDC family, to the world, that he saw Morgan.
Okay, first that he saw Morgan. Second that the letter was
to appoint,
indeed authored and signed by Morgan.
Yeah.
And you are saying Luke has not been in South Africa at the material time.
Yeah.
This is the material time is the 7th,
yeah.
presumably, because the appointment could only take place after the trip to Cape Town.
Yeah.
So what we do know is that the 7th is the cutoff date.
That's
so on the 7th, you are saying that Luke was not in South Africa.
No.
And there are people who are saying, no, look, Morgan or the family is jealous of Chamisa.
We have no jealous of people who can lead people to independence.
Okay.
But we have nothing. We don't have any bad blood with anyone.
So this is just talking
as a family member, and someone who comes after Morgan in the family.
But did you take his passport?
The passport was not taken.
What is the story?
The passport was given to Edwin so that By the time they wanted to apply for a visa in Pretoria, they had the passport so that they could go.
Mm-hmm. Whose passport is this?
Morgan's passport, Edwin's passport, and my passport too.
There was some audio circulating about the passport. Is there a dispute regarding a passport?
The dispute, I think it remains with the person who was recording the audio.
So who could be that person who then goes viral with the passport? What is the big thing about this passport?
I don't know. I don't know whether the passport can heal someone,
yeah,
or not, or if it has got medication to heal somebody who is sick.
But your brother was talking about the passport.
He was talking about the passport, but that doesn't have to be with him, because even in the hospital,
he can't move.
He cannot move anyway
without the doctor's permission.
Without the doctor's permission.
So he's a prisoner.
Now he seems a prisoner
in hospital, waiting to be treated. So he can't make his own choices.
The doctors have got to make a choice so that he can be free.
So why is this so much hype about passport? What do you think? What is going on?
Mike Brueliza was the one who was keeping the passport, and when he gave it to Edwin, we said, thank you, that's his son.
Oh, so there was somebody holding the passport.
Elizabeth, my great Elizabeth was having the passport.
I see. So this happened after the second.
Yeah.
The second is where this disappearance took place.
Yeah.
So Elizabeth takes off
and to Harare.
Is discovered miraculously in Harare.
In the evening he comes at 13 minutes past 8 that I can confirm.
You remember it was 13 minutes past?
Yeah, because I was...
And visitors are supposed what?
To be closed at
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock.
But she comes after the closing.
Yeah.
Which means she had flown from Harare.
Yeah.
But without your knowledge.
Without
your brother's knowledge.
Without my brother's knowledge, without his mom, without mother's knowledge, and so, without the knowledge of his children.
And her disappearance was known after kissing him.
Yeah, that's
correct. It was before. Or he already knew that the wife was missing in action.
I don't know.
She was sick.
Yeah, she said she was sick in the morning.
Are you sure of that?
Yeah, because my Getty, the one who travels with her,
yeah,
came in the morning and told us that she is sick. In the afternoon, when we asked my Getty to come and help us to go to the place, she refused. She disappeared.
So she didn't want to be known. She asked 22 questions.
She didn't want to know whether Mike Guru was at home or was out.
And this information gets known
today
by your brother.
I don't know whether he was
told. During the day when she came at 13 minutes past 8, did he know that she had disappeared to Harare?
No one was with Morgan at that time. I only followed and I was closed. I could not get into where they were.
So it was the day after. Did you know that Morgan now knew? Or how did you know that she was in Zimbabwe when she had said she was sick?
The relatives in Zimbabwe saw Elizabeth driving.
When the same day?
The same day.
And they called you the same day?
They called us soon after seeing her.
Before she arrived?
Before she arrived.
And obviously you leaked the information to your brother.
I didn't tell him because I didn't want to frustrate him.
So how did you know that she was missing?
Because during the day he was asking,
"Where is my wife?
Where is my wife? Where is my wife?" And they were saying, "She's coming. She's coming." We're trying to.
Now you knew.
We knew because.
So who spilled the beans?
The one who saw him in Harare.
Called Morgan.
No.
Called who?
He called us.
But then how did Morgan, in his bed, know that the wife had gone to Zimbabwe? One of us
might have said, because the time zone.
So somebody leaked and said, when she came at 13 minutes past, the man was already sick.
Was angry. Yeah.
So there was some why would my wife
leave me
with mom And she doesn't tell me what is so special in Zimbabwe that I cannot be told.
It was a simple thing. If she had said, "Mom, I'm going to Zimbabwe.
Yeah,
I'll come in the evening." Nobody would have refused him the journey to Zimbabwe. No one.
So this was a clandestine travel plan.
It was, because we don't have...
It was never supposed to be known by you.
It was never.
So she was just going to come back and fit into the family.
Yeah, that's all.
So she never explained. So from that date...
That's where the trouble came.
That's where the trouble came.
Yeah.
So there's no other mischief.
No other mischief.
That you guys were jealous of Mrora.
We are not jealous of anyone.
Trying to make sure the will is in your favor, or to rewrite the will and throw it out. So you are saying that this confirms that Morgan was very much alert for him to say no.
Yeah, Morgan was alert.
So nobody stopped the wife other than Morgan himself. He's the author of this script.
He's the author of saying, "I do not want to see you."
So this can be confirmed.
That's right.
That this is the position.
That's the position.
That's Morgan's will.
That's Morgan's
will. That my wife, you can run away from me for the day, and you end up crossing the border into Zimbabwe, and you are seen in Zimbabwe,
and come back again.
Come back and pretend that we are together.
We are together.
That's the end of the road.
That's the end of it.
I would rather be sick on my feet than on my knees.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.